With me today in the studio from Feedback, I'm joined once again by Tom Oakley. Tom, nice to see you.
Hi Andrew, nice to see you.
Since we last spoke, since we last saw you, you've been showcasing the Bleepa app at the NHS Expo. How did that go?
We had a really good time at NHS Expo. It was fantastic to have a product validated by all sorts of people from the NHS and also from outside the NHS too, both clinicians and senior management within hospitals. And off the back of that, we have quite a few leads that we are rapidly chasing down at the minute. And we're getting very close towards getting some pilots stood up within the NHS, which is exactly where we need to be at the minute. And we're kind of bang on where we should be.
And what kind of feedback, so to speak, did you get on the app? What were they telling you?
What we were hoping for, really, that this is going to be transformative for patient care. I mean, we learned that actually it can take up to 3 hours to transfer images from one center to another at the minute. Well, we can do it almost as soon as they're off the scanner and it's on your mobile phone. So if you're not in hospital, you can still receive and interact with your team about that image. So this really will accelerate the decision-making process for patients. And I think that is all we really wanted to hear from people. Mm. They're as excited about it as we are. And now we just have to move forwards and capitalize on that.
And you're going to give us a quick run through of just how it works. So just talk us through what we're seeing here, Tom.
So Andrew, this is the sort of home screen for Bleepa. So once you're in app, you'll see that there are a number of individual patients and all the studies are listed by individual patient, which is really important when you're dealing with patients because you don't want to be reporting on the wrong one. We've got permission to use all the images that are in here. Not all of them are human. In fact, we have a cat and a dog. So if I just show you, for example, this cat study, you can see an x-ray of a cat on screen. I'm capable of zooming in, and as you can see, that is of diagnostic quality, which is really important and a real USP for this product. I can show you a number of different studies, actually. So if I, for example, go in here, this is a cardiac ultrasound. I'll zoom in a little bit so it's a bit clearer. And you can see me scrolling through the echocardiogram in real speed. And you can see the heart valves moving. Again, something that is pretty incredible to be able to do. And as a radiologist, I would have loved to see that. This, for example, is an MRI, which I can scroll through with my thumb. And you can see the image quality. Again, I can zoom in. And what's particularly important is I can annotate an area of interest and ask a question about that. And that question will then go through into a group chat where we can have a dialogue as different members of the clinical team. And it will take you straight back to the slice where I've annotated the problem and off we go. So that will save so much time for so many clinical teams, and I'm really hoping that it will have a wider impact on the system that we all hope it will.
And that compares to what many people currently using, what you've said to me in the past, WhatsApp. And the like.
Yes, so part of the reason we built this was because of the problems with using WhatsApp from data security and a sort of patient confidentiality perspective. But it's also much wider than that. It's about the importance of medical imaging and clinical decision making and about us getting those images to the right clinicians at the right time, making the whole process faster. So the idea is that you will get better patient decisions faster.
And as far as the rollout, what's the model that you're looking at? Would it be a subscription base?
Yes, it is. So I think we discussed previously, the Bleepa model is a software as service model. It's based on a recurring system of revenue. We're exploring what different options might look like in the NHS and also outside of the NHS with different customer groups.
And how pricey might it be?
Oh, it'd be extremely affordable compared to current solutions. We're talking a number of pounds per user per month equivalent.
Are you looking at securing a CE mark for that at some point? Is that necessary?
Yeah, so because it's handling diagnostic medical imaging data, we are a regulated medical device, and therefore we will have to comply and undertake the regulation. We will hold a CE mark, and work is ongoing in the background to achieve that.
Right. Well, of course, the strategic review into CADRAN, that's complete.
Yes.
TexRAD, where are we at?
So I think, as I mentioned last time, TexRAD, we are still actively reviewing. It's a very complicated tool in a very complicated market. And we really want to make sure that we are clear on where the value lies for shareholders and for the company. About 2 months ago, actually, while we were talking and very much focused on Bleepa, we did actually instruct the team internally to make a product modification called GLCM, which stands for Grey Level Co-occurrence Matrix, which is a very complex and fancy term. But in essence, what it means is, if you were trying to describe a painting to me, you would describe the colours and roughly what proportion of a picture had red and blue and green in it. That's what TexRAD does. What GLCM does is it allows you to describe to me how those colours are in the picture. So there's a green circle, a red circle, a blue circle. That's kind of what GLCM adds. We don't believe that it will make a material difference, which is why we're not commenting on it as an RNS, but it has been something that has been requested by some of our active TexRAD customers, and so we're responding to those market interests. The other thing that I would like to say while we're here, as we are continuing to evaluate TexRAD as a product, we are going to be looking closely at TexRAD Lung. And because we won't be actively marketing it during that period, under our product regulations, we have to remove it from the website. So I don't want any shareholder alarmed by us doing that. It's just part of our review process. And there will be some further information about GLCM going up on the website in its place.
So Tom, what's in store for feedback between now and the end of the year? What can we look forward to?
So we hopefully will be looking to announce some NHS sites where Bleepa is up and running, maybe potentially some sites outside the NHS. There's an awful lot happening on that front, but given the complexity of the NHS, very difficult to know how quickly that will move. So I'm pushing for before Christmas, but we'll see if the NHS goes at that pace. But yes, I'm hoping we'll come out with lots of opportunities for Bleepa and hopefully some more news on TexRAD in due course.
Very good. Tom, good to see you. Thank you.
Thank you very much.